Hello, Mr. Nyren here. So we are playing Warcraft Total War, a mod for Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms. Okay, so this is the latest version 2.2, and we are going to play a hotseat campaign as the Blood Elves and the Naga. I tried to play this campaign in October last year, but there were some issues, and that version was much worse in many ways. So these factions have all their strat models finished. That's why we can play it now. I'm not done with the mod. Of course, the humans and the trolls and the dwarves and the trade coalition and the insects, they and the horde factions, they all need new strat models. And also the humans will probably get new battle models. But for now, I want to play. I released a couple of versions during April and May. I believe the latest version 2.2 was released on May 4th, 2021, and then there were some small similar updates in April. Okay, but the latest one was much bigger than the two I released in April, because it included all the changes from last year that I did between August and November. Okay, so I originally had planned to wait until I'm done with all the strat models and the new human units, but I want to play with the Blood Elves and the Naga now. Okay, and I play both of them because in Warcraft 3, the Frozen Throne, you play as Kael'Thas, the leader of the Blood Elves, and are fighting the Scourge, etc., and he is joined by Lady Vash of the Naga, and later they Kael'Thas is convinced to follow her to Illidan and then journey to Northrend, where they will join forces to fight Arthas. And as the player, you are controlling Kael'Thas and the Naga in some missions and Arthas in other missions. I believe in one of the missions you play as Arthas and kill off the Blood Elves in Northrend, or at least defeat them. I believe Kael'Thas survives, of course, but you defeat most of his forces, and then you defeat Illidan and his Naga too. Illidan survives and flees to Outland. Okay, so it makes sense to play as both of them, so we can recreate the setting of the game, of the official Warcraft 3, the Frozen Throne game. Okay, and then we will use the immersion mode too in some battles. So we will play as both. So the Sindore strengths: Sindore archmages and expert archers. Weaknesses: lacking cavalry and heavy infantry. The best unit is the blood mages. They are also their bodyguard. Okay, Sindore blood elves. So I don't know if the date is correct. It might be the date from the first campaign, the Reign of Chaos campaign. But we can't play the blood elves nor the Naga in the Reign of Chaos campaign. So we need to play the Frozen Throne campaign to play as them. Okay, I always liked their factions the most in Warcraft 3. Thought they were badass looking, especially the Naga. But otherwise, out of the four original factions, the humans, the Horde, the undead, which is basically the Scourge, and the Night Elves, I prefer the Night Elves actually. Okay, the Blood Elves, or Sindore in Talassian, Children of Blood, are a race composed of former High Elves who renamed themselves in honor of their people who were killed during the Siege of Kael'Thas by the Scourge during the Third War. During the Third War, Prince Arthas led his army of the Scourge against them, ravaging Kael'Thas and corrupting the Sunwell. Most of what was left of Kael'Thas was burned down by the High Elves in an effort to give the Scourge a psychological victory and leave the few High Elves left who were making their last stand on Sunstrider Isle. Excuse me, I'm annoyed by... I probably have a little... the sound is too high, I need to lower it more when I start the campaign. Okay, most of what was left of Kael'Thas was burned down by the High Elves in an effort to give the Scourge a psychological victory and leave the few high elves left who were making their last stand on Sunstrad. Give them a psychological victory so they would leave, the few high elves left who were making their last stand on Sunstrad Rising or higher. And despite their efforts, most of the high elven population were eradicated during the this conflict. In remembrance of their fallen brethren, most of them renamed themselves to Blood Elves or Sindore and swore to avenge their fallen race. Cut off from their source of power once again, the elves went into magic withdrawal. Desperate for aid following the Third War, the Blood Elves allied with the Naga. This was seen as treachery by the new alliance led by Kael'Thas, and they were sentenced to death. Prince Kael'Thas Sunstrider led his followers to freedom and pledged allegiance to Illidan, who promised to grant them a new source of magic by siphoning the chaotic energies of demons. So the leader of the Naga faction is Illidan, and the leader of the Blood Elven faction is Kael'Thas. And in Warcraft 3, the Frozen Throne, they were kind of the same faction at one point. The Blood Elves then followed Illidan to the Ice Crown Glacier in an attempt to destroy the Lich King. However, they were defeated by Arthas, who wounded Illidan, forcing the Blood Elves and Naga to retreat, allowing Arthas to ascend the glacier and merge with the Lich King. During the Northrend events, the most powerful Blood Elves were chosen by Arthas to serve the Scourge as Dark Fallen, members of the Sunlane. Unfortunately, the decisions of Kael'Thas to continually accept the aid of the Naga and willingness to use fell magic have caused Blood Elves to be shunned by the Alliance. Okay, and this stuff hasn't happened yet, so we are here. Cut off from their source of power once again, the elves went into magic withdrawal. Desperate for aid following the Third War, the Blood Elves allied with the Naga. And here is where the campaign starts. So this is about to happen. This was seen as treachery by the new alliance led by... I changed some stuff, so this has happened as well. This was seen as treachery by the new alliance led by Kael'Thas, the leader of Lordaeron in this campaign, and they were sentenced to death. Prince Kael'Thas answered, led his followers to freedom, pledged allegiance to Illidan, who promised to grant them a new source of magic by siphoning the chaotic energies of demons. The Blood Elves then followed Illidan to the Ice Crown Glacier in an attempt to destroy the Lich King. There is where the campaign starts. Kael'Thas starts in Uldar in Northrend. Okay, so they haven't been defeated by Arthas yet, but they have reached Northrend. Okay, as for the Naga, we need to check them as well. So strength, exotic but effective mix of sea units, weaknesses, lacking fast land units, and is a race living under the sea. The best unit, the ordinary unit, is Wrath of Ashara. Okay, so that's the old bodyguard unit, but they have a new bodyguard unit now. Okay. To win, they need to hold 50 regions and eliminate factions Lordaeron, the Night Elves, or the Scourge in the long campaign. In a short campaign, they need to eliminate the Night Elves and the Scourge. And in a long campaign, they also need to eliminate Lordaeron. Okay. We can play the long campaign. Okay, and their story... I believe I read it before when I played the Naga campaign in 2018. I never finished it because I started to update the mod after August, I believe, 2018. But I played it during the summer until sometime late in August. Then I started to update the mod again, so the saves became obsolete. Okay, so Naga are sinister Ophidian humanoids that dwell beneath the ocean. Their culture is ancient and mythical. 10,000 years ago, they were Kaldore, Night Elves. 10,000 years ago, during the reign of Queen Ashara, there was an elite magic-using sect known as the Highborne, who dabbled in magics that many other elves considered reckless and irresponsible by drawing upon the power of the Well of Eternity. The Highborne Elves enjoyed great power and comfort before the War of the Ancients. During that conflict, the Highborn sought to abuse arcane magic to bring demons to the world. This action led to the war itself, in which the Night Elves, at great cost, defeated the Burning Legion. The magical backlash shattered the world, imploded the Well of Eternity, and blasted the Highborn's capital city to the bottom of the ocean. So their capital city is named Nasratar. Is at the bottom of the ocean. Of course, we can't have that city on the campaign map in Medieval 2. So their capital in the campaign is the old Highborne, the old ruins of the area where their capital used to be. So Eldaret is their capital in the campaign. Men were cast far into the flooding depths of the great cataclysm that sundered the land and destroyed the Well of Eternity. It was Queen Ashara's quick thinking that saved them. She is thought to have managed to make a pact with the old gods on behalf of her people. Though the exact beings that transformed them are unknown, it is also possible its cursor was Neptulon, the Tidehunter, the water elemental god, lord. With the old god's curse, they started to change. Since then they have further been twisted by the residual cascading energies of the Well of Eternity. It took on new shapes, new powers, and became the hateful serpentine Naga. When the Naga awakened, they set about building a new life for themselves on the ocean depths within the abyssal sea trench beneath the swirling waters of the maelstrom. They built their new When the Naga awakened, they set about building a new life for themselves on the ocean depths within the abyssal sea trench beneath the swirling waters of the maelstrom. They built their new city, Nasratar. Shara herself expanded with hate and rage, becoming a massive monstrosity, reflecting the wickedness and malice that had always hidden within her core. For 10,000 years, these elves of the abyss dwelt in a dark and powerful empire. Pagodas and balconies lined the deep trenches, glimmering lights picking out the shapes of cities in the cold black. Sinuous figures drift and twist along the passageways, their elven origins difficult to discern. There in the depths of the ocean for 10,000 years, the Naga plotted their revenge against the Night Elves. Most Naga are still content to wait. However, a small group led by the Naga Sea Witch, Lady Vash, answered a summons from Illidan Stormrage to aid him in his quest to destroy the Frozen Throne. Lady Vash joined forces with Illidan and his forces in order to serve her own ends. Future events in the Frozen Throne that is yet to happen. So here is where the story ended. Here is where we start. Okay, future events in the Frozen Throne that is yet to happen. It has kind of happened to some extent, because I moved the start forward since 2018. In the old version, I believe the Naga and the Blood Elves started in Eastern Kingdoms, but in the new version they started in Northrend. Lady Vash and Kael'Thas has been moved to Northrend. Okay, they made new allies in the form of their highborn kin, the Blood Elves. Yeah, that has happened, as well as enemies of the Night Elves and the Alliance. That has also happened. They started war with the Lordaeron and Night Elves. They aided Illidan in the recovery of the Eye of Shargeras, that hasn't happened yet, and fought alongside the Blood Elves to take Outland as well as at the Icecrown Glacier against the Scourge. That hasn't happened, that's what we are going to do. We can't take Outland because Outland isn't in the game, but the Icecrown Glacier, that's certainly one of the goals of the campaign. Okay, after suffering defeat at the hands of Arthas, this group retreated back to Outland with Illidan. The exact ends for Vash's alliance with Illidan remain unknown. Okay, so we are at the point where they have reached Northrend, but not everyone is in Northrend. I believe their leader Illidan is still in Kalimdor and has yet to attack Nendis and take it from the Night Elves and then go to this area, the Eyre in the sea, where the Eye of Sargeras is located. So they have still not really moved everything from Kalimdor. So probably the Naga will have to defeat the Night Elves, or at least fight some battles against them, and then they need to move to this Eyre and get that place so they can get the Eye, and then they need to move from the Eyre to Northrend. So the Eyre with the Eye of Sargeras is in the middle between Kalimdor and Northrend. Okay, and the Blood Elves, they have half of their forces in Eastern Kingdoms defending the Sunwell and the Silver Moon that they have reconquered, and the other two armies out of four are in Northrend. So they will need to fight in both Eastern Kingdoms and in Northrend. And in Northrend they do not only have the Scourge to fight, but they also have other enemies like the Azul Nerub faction, the Ice Trolls, the Drakari, and the Vrykul. They have the Scarlet Crusade, the Goblins, yeah, but they have the Naga as an ally. And then in Eastern Kingdoms they have the Amani Trolls as an enemy and not just the Scourge. Then further back they have behind the Scourge and the Amani there are Scarlet Crusaders, and they are also enemies of the Blood Elves. And then they have Lordran, another enemy, and of course the Forsaken. I don't think they are, if they are not enemies, they are at least a neutral faction. They are not an ally at least. Okay, so we need to have 50 regions. That will be one of the goals. Will take a while to get. And we need to kill Lordaeron, but maybe they will be killed by someone else. They do not have any Eyres anymore. I believe the Kael'Thas Eyre has been moved to Terramore, and Menethil Harbor has been moved to the Kasmodan Dwarves. So Lordaeron only has Dalaran. Start with a small force in Dalaran, then they have Garritos, Marshal Garritos, the leader, starting outside of Lordaeron with a huge army, ready to fight Sylvanas Windrunner, the undead Sylvanas Windrunner, and her huge army of Forsaken. So if he wins, he can reclaim Lordaeron, but if he loses to Sylvanas or to the Scourge, which is holding most of this territory, then, or to the Scarlet Crusaders, they have two areas here, then he is likely to lose, but in some cases he may be able to reclaim Lordaeron. And we need to defeat Lordaeron to win. But that's not the main focus. The main focus for the Naga is to fight the Night Elves in the beginning. And then move forces to Northrend to fight the Scourge. As for the Blood Elves, in the short campaign they need to hold 30 regions, including Southern Kael'Thas, Northern Kael'Thas, Eyre of Kael'Thas, and Everson Woods, Northeastern Kael'Thas, and they need to eliminate factions, the Scourge and the Mani Trolls. So their goal in the short campaign is to take all these areas back. Probably they only have they have this Eyre, the Sunwell, and they have Silver Moon here. They need to take back all of this and defeat the Scourge and the Mani to win. So the Scourge has a huge presence here, and then they have a huge presence here, so they still need to go to Northrend and fight. They have some armies here too. Okay, and because this map is not really correct to their locations in the Frozen Throne campaign. Okay, and then the Amani Trolls, they have some areas here, some areas further down here, and some areas here, I believe. Okay, so they need to do a lot in Eastern Kingdoms and then defeat the Scourge here. In the long campaign, they need 50 regions. So 20 more regions, the same areas needs to be held, and Lordaeron needs to be killed as well. Lordaeron only has one area here to start, as I said. So we will play the long campaign, of course, and very hard difficulty for the campaign, so the AI will be the best it can be when moving troops and such as aggressive as possible. But we will have medium in battle, because having harder difficulty than medium just means they get bonuses. So if you have two armies that are even in size and strength, then the AI would be given bonuses to stats and such, which would make them win the battle, because they are given bonuses. So we will let battles be fair by having them medium. No bonuses to anyone, and no battle time limit, and we'll manage all cities. Show CPU moves could be fun, but I don't really need that. Oh, and I think I have solved the problem with that was in the Trade Coalition campaign. I will replay that, by the way, and restart it. But in the Trade Coalition campaign, I played one episode for about 2 hours and 45 minutes or something. And in that campaign, I couldn't play defensive battles when the AI attacked me. And if that is still the case, we will exit. But if it's fixed, like I think it should be, because it worked in the past, I don't know why it didn't work in that campaign. Somehow the .cfg file had been changed, and I don't know how that had happened. But anyway, if it's still an issue, we'll restart it. If it's not an issue, we'll play. Okay, so we are playing two factions. We'll use the immersion mode when we can. So let's start the campaign then. So I already played like 1 hour 40 minutes in October last year as the Naga and the Blood Elves in this cooperative style of a campaign, in a hot seat campaign. But that was an old version, so not the same thing. They had different starting positions for some heroes and no unique custom threat models, at least no new ones. As you can see, the Blood Elves have this spy. Previously they had a really ugly spy, a human spy with the skin. So this spy is much better. Okay, we will we can't see too much, that's good. We will move her outside of Torvata, held by the Aman in this campaign. In the other campaign, the Reign of Chaos campaign, I believe it's held by rebel trolls. They have Tressin, a general here, with a bodyguard of Amanishi champions. Really good unit. They have some Amanishi berserkers, Amanishi savages, and troll raptor archers. Okay, only the troll raptor archers had a unit info card. So this is the spy, really good model. We use the archer, this variation. Okay, they have new starting armies. They are no longer built up of everything in their army, but they are still pretty elite. I believe most factions have early and basic troops, but the Blood Elves got medium and elite troops because they have a lot of enemies and need to be able to survive for a bit. Okay, we also have the garrison script, so if the Blood Elves or anyone else is controlled by the AI, then when they are attacked by the player or the AI, they will spawn some troops, and that helped a lot for the Blood Elves in the campaigns. I've seen campaigns where they have actually expanded on turn 100 or something. They have started to expand, they have reconquered these areas and started to expand down here. In the old versions, the Blood Elves would always be defeated. Always. This place would fall almost immediately, and then to take quite long until someone landed here, but they would lose the Sunwell 2, and then they didn't have any areas in Nordrend. But in this campaign now they do have that, because they had in Frozen Throne, they had some areas on the shores of Nordrend, but there were no spots that were suitable, with the exception of Ulduar, the only Citadel level. Okay. So, we have a priest here. It was in the old version 2. One of the better strat models that Bantu made for this faction. We can just leave the priest there. We will take a look at the buildings So we need a port. I will build a merchant's wharf. It will provide trade fleets available. One increase in tradable goods. We can use that. And here too, we need a port. An elven port here. Increases in tradable goods. We get transports as well. Also, by the way, I've added pictures for the agents now. So the priest has a proper agent picture. Maybe not the unit info picture, but it has the unit card. The reason it doesn't have a unit info picture is because it's not been made for the battle model yet. Okay, so we have some units over there starting buildings in their starting cities. We can see that they have a castle upgrade, Hawkstrider breeder. So we can recruit Silver Guard Lancers, Blood Knights, Hawkstrider Knights, and Arcane Guardians. We have the castle upgrade, which provides extra wall defenses. Reinforced gates, number of free upkeep units 5, public order bonus due to law 15%, recruitment slots allowed 3. We have the Elven Garrison Quarters. So, enable training of Elven Initiates, their militia, Elven Swordsmen, pretty much their footmen, Elven Silver Guards, I think they are like pikemen, really good elite pikemen, and Spellbreakers, spearmen. In Warcraft 3 they were also mages, but it looked better to have them as spearmen. Or at least Panther Swords, so they can't shoot anything. Okay, we have the units we have. You can see that we have the Elven Initiates. They have a shield. Like the Scarlet Crusade. It's a Scarlet Crusade shield. Spellbreakers. And we have archers. Silver Guard Lancers. Ah, that's not... Elven Silver Guards are the pikemen. And Silver Guard Lancers are the cavalry version. Okay. We have Arcane Guardians like golems. We have minor giants. Elven Rangers, Elite Archers, based on a Sylvanas model, but Sylvanas herself has a different model. In this campaign she is the undead Sylvanas and is the leader of the Forsaken, and in the Reign of Chaos campaign we have the blue version of this Ranger as the Ranger unit, and then she has a unique version, a unique skin. But this could have been her if she was ever a Blood Elf, and the blue one used as a Ranger in that campaign. Could have been her as well. It is her, but we used it as the unit, so then I used another skin for the hero to make her different. Okay, we have Hawkstrider Riders. So cavalry using these birds, Hawkstriders. Blood Knights, another cavalry unit with a horse mount. Both of these are using horses. Okay, we have one agent, the priest. But they started with a spy as well. Okay, as for units, should I recruit anything? I don't know. We have two great armies. I want a fleet as fast as possible. Also, we have two armies here. I know that Prince Arthas will spawn soon, but I think it's kind of cheating to, you know, have two armies against one, so we'll move this army down here and attack Tunkaloo held by Tonka rebels. So we'll attack that area with Halderon Brightwing. He has a unique custom model, by the way. It's a Brightwing Vindicator's model. The reason he got that is because he is a Brightwing Vindicator in lore. So we use that model for him on the map and in battle. Okay, Prince Kael'Thas also has a unique model. It looks like this on the map. In the Reign of Chaos campaign he has a blue skin in both battle and on the map. Okay, but we will move him into Uldar. So Uldar has no buildings at the start. But we can build some dirt roads. Actually, we won't do that. We need buildings we can build troops, I think. Could be good to have archers. We'll go for that. A hunter's lodge. So Prince Arthas, the Death Knight. Death Knight Arthas will invade in one turn. That's why we will have to fight a battle. See if our army is up to the task of defeating Arthas. Okay. This army will handle the Tonka over there. You can also see that the Scourge has taken this area already in this campaign. We need a fleet either to evacuate Kael'Thas and his general or to send more armies from here. But we also need to hold Silvermoon. I believe the Sunwell is pretty well defended because it's on an ire, but it can be attacked, so we need an army there too. But about attacking here, so we have Verisa Windrunner here. She has a unique strat model, by the way. This is Verisa on the map, and in battle she will look the same. And we have Prince Lord Tamar here. He's a Blood Knight here. In the Reign of Chaos campaign, he is a Knight of Kael'Thas, so he has become a Blood Knight in this campaign. He's the only one with that strat model. And Risa is the only one with the Green Ranger look. And then I believe in the Reign of Chaos campaign there is another guy with this model too, but he died during that war. So he's not available in this campaign, in the Frozen Throne campaign. Okay. So, we can recruit stuff in Silvermoon. Elven Destroyers. An Elven Destroyer can engage an enemy with its firepower. I believe we have ships here. Then I don't need to build a port here. Diplomat. Large Elven Farms. Hawk Talon Voltrars. Heavy mail. Still will go for that because it's giving additional trade. But as for units, you can see that I have now the sorceress as the diplomat and a unit of I believe the elven initiates are used, their car is used for the merchant, and the merchant is a male civilian blood elf, so it's not correct to the unit, but it's the best I had in unit card variation. I could have taken a card probably in the, I believe in the milk shape 3D program of the actual merchant. I will probably do that later and replace this guy. But the sorceress is correct, and the same with the spy. The only difference is that she doesn't have a bow as a spy, so I will probably make a different card for her later. We have the priest, and then we have the assassin, and she has a different card compared to the actual assassin in battle. The card for the assassin in battle is more zoomed in from the stomach and up, while I had an older card that I didn't use for the battle model that I did first, where I had more of her body, and I used that for the agent to make it different, because that agent looks exactly like that. Okay, so we have I believe I want a fleet. Elven Destroyers and frigates. Okay, so we can move the army. But on the other hand, it would be nice to advance somewhere. They are pretty weak in Torvata. It's more important to strike at the Scourge. Maybe it's easier to hold a settlement than to actually attack. So I think we will wait there for now with Verisa and her army. We won't do anything with this army either, but I will probably move Prince Lord Tamar here to Eastern Kingdoms to aid Verisa. Unless I move him to Northrend. I have removed the rebels, the pirate spawns and the rebel spawns. They can still spawn, but I put it at 9999 chance or percentage, which means they are very, very rare now in the past they were the same as in the Warhammer mode, like 108 or 200 or whatever, and they were spawning pretty often. They were very common, and it's annoying to have to fight smaller stacks of rebels. But they can still show up, but they are rare now, so it should be much safer to move a ship or a fleet in the ocean to reach Nordrend or something. Okay. Could I do anything else? So in the sun, well, we can also recruit. Yeah, I think we'll go for Elven Initiates, Archers, Spellbreakers there. Okay, and we have this spy here. We can move it, or her, we can move her here. I love this, how it looks, really good model. Okay, so we will probably also have to place this in the middle and put automatic taxes only. So we have already seen the victory conditions. Our capital city is Silver Moon. Faction leader is King Kael'Thas. Greatest general is the same guy. We have four generals and three regions, as you have seen. We have one city and two castles. And the year might be wrong. Diplomacy, allies, the Naga, and we are at war with the rebels, the minor factions in this game, made up of different creatures and such. We have the Mani trolls, the border here, the Scarlet Crusade, further down here, they also have a presence in Nordrend, I believe here somewhere, here probably. And then we are at war with the Scourge and Lordaeron. Okay, so our only ally is the Naga, the other faction we are playing. Okay, next turn. So now we are controlling the Naga. As we can see, we have Illidan Stormrage, Demon Hunter Illidan in Eldar at their capital. We are using strat model cities and battle model cities from Lana Euro province of Herald War. And I wrote the World Classic Ultimate in this mod for the Naga. They fit perfectly, but in battle they are skinned. And some of the cities are skinned on the map as well, like this one. It has a different skin in Hyrule. While this one, I believe, might also be reskinned. Yeah, I think all of them were reskinned. However, this one doesn't fit with the battle model. In battle it has a blue look, but in on the map it has a green one. Bandy probably forgot how we made it in battle, because we did the battle version in 2018, and then these strat models were made in, I believe, 2020, so he probably forgot about the old look. But they don't look like in Hyrule, but it's the models from Hyrule. Okay, how to manage. Place this in the middle. Capital city is Eldaret. Faction leader is Demon Hunter Illidan. And same guy is the greatest general. We have 11 generals here. And the regions controlled 11. Cities are 10. And we have one castle. And that's the info. We are allied to the Sindori Blood Elves. They have the areas in Nordrend and in EK, as we saw. Then we are also allied to the Burning Legion, and they only have a presence in Kalimdor here. No longer in Eastern Kingdoms, like in the Reign of Chaos campaign, because they were defeated badly. They are no longer led by Archimonde, they are instead led by Kil'jaeden in this campaign. Okay. So we are at war with more factions. We are at war with the rebels, we are at war with the Vriku, the Amani Trolls, Ankirai, Scarlet Crusade, Scourge, the Night Elves, Terramor, and Lordaeron. Okay. So we can build some stuff. First of all, we'll get the Elven Dockyard if we already had some airport. Okay. I think they need better troops, to be honest. Let's go for the Leather Tanner. can already recruit a bunch of troops, including some new ones that were disabled previously. So we have agents too. You can see that this is not a unit, it's the spy. The spy is now a satyr, shadowstalker. Then we have the assassin, which is the humanoid form of the demon hunter, but we only had the picture of the demon. And we have the diplomat, which is now I believe the old general is the diplomat, but previously we had this one, the Medusa. Now it's the Naga siren. Okay, we have the merchant, and which is a sea witch, and we have the priest, which is a Naga oracle. Then we have some ships, giant dragon turtles. That's I believe this is a ship, and same with the sea serpent and the dragon turtle. Alright, but the snapdragons is a new unit. They're now working properly. We have hydras and Naga sea snakes. So the sea serpents are ships and the sea snakes are an actual unit. Okay, later we can get these turtles and other stuff as units too, but they are not available at the start. So the capital is a large city. We need a fifth level, a huge city, to get the best stuff, their giants and such. Okay. So they have some varied units, but no elite units, and not all of their units anymore. Okay, we can check the other areas. So, by the way, so the general, the soldier of the Naga now looks like this. It's more correct to how they looked in Warcraft 3 and in the cinematic. In the old version they were green and didn't have this weapon. Okay. And then Illidan himself actually looks like Illidan now. He has his own model. Battle too, but unfortunately the animations are bugged in battle, because the animation for Illidan isn't the generic general's animation, because he's bigger than and taller than a normal general. But on the strat map, it's made to fit his model. That's why it looks perfect on the map. Okay, we also have this area now in the Frozen Throne campaign. So we have a sea giant from the start, but his strat model is not a sea giant. I might need to change that later. I want all the custom generals to have their own models. And I forgot about this one. Okay, so they will probably get a sea giant strat model in at some point. So we have a sea giant from the start, that's cool. Rurgas, but his army sucks. He only has a bunch of murlocs. But himself, he's a giant. Okay, he just needs a model on the map. Okay, and we have some warlords. Warlord Tristis here, the unique Rat of Ashara model. Now it's the blue one instead of the green one. But this model was used as the old general, but the green skin instead of the blue. We thought that the blue look is more correct for how the Naga looked in Warcraft 3, the Frozen Throne. So instead of having many different colors, we made all of them bluish. Okay, same here. We have Warlord Atop the Blood Cursed. The soldiers are the guardians of the Abyss. They are smaller, with the tridents there. We have Lord Sinclair, another one with this model. And Warlord Kael'Thas. So all the warlords are using the Rat of Ashara model. Then we have a really cool one. Nientus, the royal guard of the Naga. He has his own unique model, the only one with this much bigger royal guard model. So he's really badass looking, the unique weapon. Okay, and down here we have General Skishes, another Rat of Ashara general. Okay, and that's all the ones in Kalimdor. Let's check the construction of all the cities now. So we need the buildings, we can get troops, snapdragons. I think we need long range units against the night elves. So we will go for the Hunter's Lodge. Murloc Slave Pit in Solar Cell, the Ire. And then here I think we could convert... I don't know... Yeah, I think we'll convert Motten Bailey here on the Ire. The Blood Mist Village here will be converted to Motten Bailey. Murloc camp is also held by the Naga. We have an army here of Murlocs and a general, a Murloc general. We would also like that general to be a Murloc if there is room for it. I don't think we have room for it, though. But let's convert it to a Motten Bailey. So we can recruit something. Because otherwise we can just build civilian stuff. Can't recruit anything from villages, it seems. So let's convert it. And we have Rainspeaker, where Lady Vash has moved. So instead of starting down here in South Shore, she is now starting here in Rainspeaker. And her army is also starting here. It's smaller now. Let's convert it to Motten Bailey. And instead, Stromgarde, the Kingdom of Stromgarde, has taken over Satchor. And we have this area. So, Lady Vash is a new model. She had a custom model in some earlier versions released in April, but in the latest version, she got a new skin. So the body textures are that of Lady Vash now from World of Warcraft, so she looks like herself. However, the armor is still that of the Medusa Matriarchs in battle. On the strat map we couldn't have the armor because it was too high poly. I would have needed to lower the polygons. They didn't bother. Of course I had a unique armor for her too, but then we needed to rig it, and I rigged one model. One strat model as of yet, and it took me 1.5 days to do, so I like to avoid that. Adding skins is a very fast matter, and adding making battle models into strat models also is a fast matter. But sometimes you need to add the textures and stuff to move everything. Usually a battle model has two textures, one for the body and one for the weapons and helmets and such, for the gear, and you need to combine them into one for some heroes. Others only have one texture from the start. That helps. Okay, but for some units that have too much polygon, they are too heavy for the strat map, it will crash when you try to load the strat map with them. Then you need to lower the model, and when you lower the model you need to rig that part of the model. There were a fairy general in the mod, Harultal War Classic Ultimate, that I had to rig from scratch pretty much, and it took me a long time to do. It had a vertex glitch as well, and that glitch in particular made the textures stand out in all directions. It looked very glitched and bugged, and to fix that took me a lot of time, 1.5 days. So I like to avoid needing to solve that type of problem. Of course I will go back to trying to rig a unit later, but for now I want to just convert from battle to the map, because that's less work and less of a bother. I don't like spending like a day on one model because it has a lot of issues and such. But I needed that model to look perfect or good. I wanted it to look good. I didn't want it to look like a buggy mess, and I didn't want another model to have its place. Okay, but that model might have been extra troublesome because it was also it had the same vertex glitch in battle. So. And the battle model still isn't fixed. Okay. I forgot that in Riplash Strand we have the General Vidya, and she has the same model as a merchant. She is a sea witch. Okay. So, we'll see what we can build in Rain Speaker. We are converting, okay. And then in Ripple Strand, we need a building so we can recruit troops there too. We will go for the Murloc Slave Pens. It will give us satyrs and Murlocs. And in Arkoran, I forgot about that. Arkoran, we will just upgrade into a Mott and Bailey. Then we have the ruins of Metistra convert. No problem with the village. I think it looks good, but I want units, and it seems we can't recruit from the village level. Because the only building we can construct is the small elven farms and the wooden palisade, which is just a wall to defend. I want actual buildings that enables the recruitment of units. Okay, so about moving troops. Could be attacked by the Night Elves. So maybe we should move somewhere. Leave one of the Myrmidons here and move this general. Move Nyentus. Then move the. I believe we can move everything but the Myrmidon. Ah, we can't move him this time. I moved him out. Good. We move the army then. So we have a larger force here now. Can build a fort, but I don't really need that right now. So we are converting all of these ruins, as I can see. There are some rebel areas here held by Furbolgs that we could take as well. Okay, usually the Night Elves will take them otherwise, and later the Horde. Okay, so Nordrasil, the tree, should be destroyed in this campaign, but I don't really know how to remove the settlement from the map. I have my ideas, but I haven't tried to remove an actual city from the map. So, without using a tool, and I can't make that tool work anymore, the Geomod tool. So without that tool, I don't know how to remove it. I know it's possible in GIMP and in Photoshop. I use GIMP for a lot of stuff, but I've never tried to remove settlements. I believe Renat helped me to remove the area that was here. Nax Ramaz, I believe, and Fenris Ire here, and the area down here. It used to be named, there was an area here named Map by the Happy Crusader. All of them were unnecessary, because Fenris Ire, you could use it as the player, but the AI could never invade it. But the armies, if an AI lord or an army, we're defeated here, they could retreat here, then they never left. So Lordran would never be defeated if they held this area from the start. That's why I made it ungarrisoned, because I didn't want anyone to hold it, but that just enabled the player to take it for free. So it's better to remove it. And this area, Nax Ramaz, held by the Blue Dragonflight's rebels. It was also unnecessary because armies, Scourge and others, tried to go there in the late game but got stuck here because they can't go there this way. There's supposed to be a port here, and there is a port here where ships can move, but there is supposed to be a pass here so they can move, but it doesn't work because the pathing here is too far, too disconnected from this area. So it was better to remove this area so that when they conquer the Red Dragonflight base here, they get this area too, and therefore own all of this so they can focus on other targets. Otherwise they will try to get to Nax Ramaz, but can't, so they will just assemble a bunch of troops here. And with the map by the Happy Crusader, it was a waste of a slot, but not only that, I saw the Burning Legion take this area. So better to remove. So we have three slots for settlements now. We used to have the maximum number of settlements, 199, but now we have taken up, we have freed up 3 slots by removing those areas. Okay, and of course Nordra Sil should be removed in this campaign, but for now it's still in. The difference is it has no buildings at the start in the Frozen Throne campaign. But in Reign of Chaos it has a lot of starting buildings. Okay. So they can attack from Starfall over here, and they can attack from Aberdeen here. Aberdeen. Okay. So moving troops could help defend, but we don't really know if they will attack there. So let's go for some units then. So we need ships. 500, 800, that's not a ship. 4,400, 520. Giant Dragon Turtles, 518, 817. So the Sea Serpents are countless better than the Giant Turtles. That's interesting. I believe this is not a ship, this is the actual unit. The land unit, I think. Okay. So I think we can go for some Giant Dragon Turtles and Sea Serpents. Okay, and need a fleet, and could also probably use a spy. Maybe we should wait with that for now. We need troops, we don't have a full force here. So what troops do we need? Can go for Hydras, Naga Sea Snakes, and Dragon Turtles to begin with in this area. And I don't think we can recruit in any other place. Ah, we have an area there. We can get a merchant, we'll go for that. Okay, we're done. We didn't have any agents at the start, so we'll need to get that too later. So we'll build up our troops before advancing anywhere. Let's end the turn. Princess return. Prince Art has many tales back from his journey to Northrend, but he's not the same person anymore. Influenced by a dark sword named Frostmourne, he has turned against his own people and now has joined the ranks of the Scourge. In the old version, he used to spawn in the Eastern Kingdoms. Now he spawns in Northrend. Okay, so that text probably needs to be changed. Take rebel settlement. Time remaining 15 turns. Source Council of Nobles. Description. Our great nation appears weak to solar. Yeah. We need to take Tunkalu. Yeah, I'm about to do that. Let's attack. So the enemy has Tunka Braves. Smaller Tauren and one leader general with the Tunka Warhorns. The bigger ones. They are the biggest Tauren. Okay. Can attack. But how long can it last? 2 turns. I think we will wait. As you can see, Death Knight Artas has spawned here with a huge force. I believe he has better troops than we have, because our army is no longer made up of entirely of all the elites. We have the mages too, but we do not have any giants and such. Okay, Artas Manitil, the Death Knight. He has a bodyguard of Death Knights. And his units, actually we can wait with checking him out. End of turn report. So we can see that we are the second strongest faction in the world. That's because we have elite troops to some degree, while other factions start with basic and medium troops for the most part. I believe some factions have elites other than the Naga. I believe the Blood Elves and the Scarlet Crusade have good troops at the start, but the others have only a few elite troops. at the start. Maybe some of them don't even have that, but for the most part it's just the Scarlet Crusade and the Blood Elves that have been boosted, because they are very weak when it comes to number of regions and the fact they have a huge number of enemies that are neighboring them. Okay, so we are the second strongest faction at the start of the campaign. The Scourge is the strongest one. We are the 8th best in financial matters, and the Burning Legion has the best financial situation. Our production is the 11th biggest in the world, largest in the world, but the Scourge has the best production, the Scourge has the largest population. We are also the 11th largest population. Overall, we are at place number 3 in the world, and the Scourge is number 1. Okay, we can move the spy. We have a Scourge army here. You can see that the army is now consisting of basic and medium troops, unlike before. So they have undead soldiers, undead halberds, skeleton soldiers. I believe these are medium troops, and this is a basic troop. They have some undead, skeleton soldiers, undead surgeons, another medium soldier unit. Okay, human skeletons, that's basic. I believe it's basic, 70, yeah. And they have some skeleton raiders, so they are basic cavalry. Really weak cavalry, worse than most other cavalry in the game. There's some zombies, they are numerous but extremely bad basic troops. I believe almost no other unit is as bad as the zombies, but they are very numerous and never break. None of the undead for the Scourge breaks, but the zombies, their role is probably just to hold back armies for a while. Okay, we have the skeleton archers, basic archers or such. And the trolls, a medium unit, but it's a basic troll unit, but it's undead and it's bigger trolls. So. Okay. I think we can keep the spy there for now. So we have gotten a ship, that's perfect. Let's move the ship. Time to move the army of Prince Lord Tamar to the fleet and move in these troops into the Sunville. Yes. Believe these troops could do well against the Scourge.
Yes, my lord.
So this army could prepare to fight the Scourge here. We'll use Lord Tamar to attack the Scourge in this area. So we have recruitment report. We got Elven Destroyers in Silver Moon and Frigates, and then in Sun we got Elven Initiates, Archers and Spellbreakers. We are still constructing the Merchant's Wharf, and we will get some new stuff. We could go for an Assassin and a diplomat, actually. So go for agents in Silver Moon. And in the Sun, well, we can go for some troops. I believe it could be good with maybe some cavalry. So we got Lancers, Blood Knights, and Hawkstrider Knights. And in Northrend we are besieging Tunkalo. We'll wait 2 turns, they will probably give up. And in Ulduar we can stop constructing because we are under siege. We are still constructing an Elven port in the Sunville. And in Silver Moon we are also constructing a Merchant's Wharf. Okay, so in Ulduar we can't do much, but did a mistake in trying to construct a building that takes 2 turns to construct. Settlement besiege Ulduar the Scourge, yes. Okay, end turn. A candidate for adoption. Okay, we can use another general. Now we got another general here. The bodyguard. We have a trade coalition fleet here. Some goblin submarines. They still do not have any portraits. So we are not planning to attack yet. We can upgrade this to a wooden castle. We'll do that immediately. So it will take a while for them to finish it. Probably will take 3 turns. In Eldaret we can now... we are still constructing and recruiting there. In Arkoran, I believe it's better to go for a building where we can get some troops. We'll go for the Murloc camp, and in Eldaret we'll just continue to construct whatever is being constructed. In the ruins of Matistra, we can now see that the Night Elves have sent an army outside. 11 archers. Elite archers. But with no armor. And Night Elven spearmen, basic troops. But all the Night Elven troops are good. We have better. The Naga have better infantry, probably. Okay, so we can go for. Let's go for the Murloc camp. I believe they will probably attack me. So we won't waste any money there. In the ruins of Bachelor, and we can go for the Murloc camp. And here too. In Nashvel, our castle, we are still constructing the Hunter's Lodge. Here we have a Night Elven priest. It's a new strat model from the latest version. Okay, so we have a general inside of the ruins of Emmet Aaron. We'll move a Myrmidon there. Move this general towards our burden. This general can move out as well. End of turn report. We are now at place 6 militarily and 4 overall, so we are being weakened compared to before. Agent recruited. We have a merchant in Solarsong. We'll go there. Don't need another merchant now. We could move this merchant out. Move down there. So the merchants for the Naga are sievages. Okay, trade increase. Minus 1 loyalty. Lord Sinslayer feels unappreciated. This man is quite disgruntled at how he has been treated of late and is losing loyalty. Okay, that's not good. Ready to trade. Lord Sinslayer. Okay, in this area we are still constructing the Murloc slave pens. Okay. Continue with that. We can't recruit any troops, only merchants there. In this area, we're also constructing. In the Blood Mist Ire, your settlement, we will go for the Murloc camp. It's a waste to try and build two turns, one turn. Actually, we can go for the Murloc camp in the ruins of Matistra. Okay, and in Northrend, we have quite a few rebels to fight before we can reach any of the enemy troops. Continue to build there, we can't recruit any troops. And here too, Murloc camp and nothing else. I don't think we have any agents besides that merchant, no. Okay, end turn. So the Night Elves decided to finally attack. They attacked the weak general. Let's retreat. Fuck, they will take out my general. Lord Sinslayer. Shouldn't I move the army first? Should I have merged it first and then moved? Too bad. So we will lose Lord Sinslayer. Because they are attacking me with an army. They have Night Elven Spearmen. Night Elven Warriors. Night Elven Archers. We have two units of Warriors. Two units of Night Elven Spearmen. They have the Night Elven Volunteers Militia. So this is the Militia unit. The others are their basic troops. This is a really good Archer unit, but it's the worst one in their army. So it's like their basic Archer, but still elite compared to many other races. Then they have the Mounted Night Elven Warriors basic cavalry. Okay. And yeah, we will save the game. Naga Sin Torek Hoop. Okay, so I did a mistake. I shouldn't have retreated on the strat map, but if I had entered the battle and retreated, he would have retreated back to the ruins of Amet Aran. But I retreated on the map, so he was hunted down. Too bad, we will lose Lord Sinslayer. Come forth, Lord Archimonde, enter this world and let us bask in your power. Kael'Thas, Archlich of the Scourge. Start deployment. So Lord Sinslayer in battle is a random rat for Shara. I didn't add the specific blue one for him in battle. They have the new bodyguard. In past, the bodyguard was the rat for Shara, but in order to make Lady Vash look good, we used the Medusa Matriarchs instead. And they look better. So we'll lose one of these. We do not have any stakes. I removed stakes from this mod, I believe, because it's so easy to cheat by placing stakes at the gates, and then the enemy will just send all their cavalry there and they will die. So in order to prevent people from using that, cheap way of winning battles, I removed the stakes. Okay, start the battle. They are moving forward, their troops. So this is the militia unit. Night Elven Volunteers, consisting of both men and women. Then we have the warriors here. The first armor variation, it's colorful. They have a second armor variation that is more purple and uniform. This is the first variation of the Night Elven Spearmen. They are in shield formation, I believe. Then we have the archers. Night Elven Archers, and we have the Mounted Night Elven Warriors riding tigers or sabers. Okay, so we can now fire at them at least, but they have some upper hand. We can't retreat because I did a mistake of retreating on the strat. They need to fight to the death. Lord Sinslayer and his bodyguard of Medusa Matriarchs. Enemy didn't have any general. Sucks that I lost one of the custom generals. But we have more of this type. He's not the only one. Still sucks to lose him this early. The Night Elves decided to attack the lone general instead of the army. Cowards. Okay, we are starting to fire. So this unit has the same projectiles as the ballista. So it's like ballista barrage being fired upon the units by many at advance. Many ballista shots, pretty much. They are pretty good. At least from a distance. Now the Night Elven archers will start to fire. This unit is fan-made from Warcraft 3 Underground, while the General is of course a World of Warcraft Classic model. Okay, and the same is with these archers, they are also from Warcraft 3 Underground, while the, I believe the basic troops and the volunteers, they are from World of Warcraft. The Tigers are from World of Warcraft Classic as well, WoW Classic, or WoW Classic. Well, the, yeah, so a mix of fan-made Warcraft 3 models and WoW Classic models.
Only half the enemy force remains.
Good, we've killed half of them. Awesome. Kill them. Problem is, they will probably kill me when I enter melee. When the unit enters melee, they will not be as OP. Let's kill the tigers, by the way. I forgot to fire at the tigers. They're the biggest problem in melee. Would have been good to fire at them. I forgot. So they have giant swords in melee. They are not worthless in melee, but they will probably lose. I didn't even bother playing this battle in with the immersion mod. Because I thought I would lose. Kind of fucked up. 56% enemies killed, 2% allies killed, but they still have the numerical advantage. So I think we are screwed. Naga are also very slow, so we couldn't outrun the Night Elves and the fire from a different position. Especially not outrun their tigers, but even without the tigers they would be able to run us down with just the infantry. Their infantry is much faster on land. I made them slower because they are serpents. They are not that fast, you know. They are the slowest faction in the game. Have some cavalry, but every other unit is pretty slow.
I pray the course of this battle changes.
So they will have to stand their ground instead. So, close formation. The general is still alive. Fighting these volunteers. So they, by the way, have the civilian animation from Herald of War. So they will spread out and move to all directions if left standing. That's why they are also fighting more separate from other units.
Lord preserve us! We have lost half of
it's
our
not
men.
Looking good. 62% enemy skill, 54% ally skill. They will soon catch up. Our barrage of fire didn't prevent them from winning.
I pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain.
Fuck, they took out one of the generals. Lord Sinslayer himself. Minor general, but still a custom one. We have about 7 or so, 6 maybe, of these generals in the game. The start, we'll get no more of them. They are not the generic generals. The generic generals are the Medusa Matriarchs, these female Naga. So this is one of the unique ones, but they are still about 6 or so. Still sucks that we lost them. My goal with the campaign is to follow the story of the Frozen Throne game. while at the same time trying to combine the Naga and the Blood Elves in a united front and keep Illidan and Kael'Thas alive. So you need to win the the battle against Orthus. Otherwise I have fucked up already. But the Naga never really destroyed the Night Elves in lore. But we will still weaken the Night Elves enough so they are not a big threat against us. The goal was to take Nendis with Illidan, then move to the Ire, where the Eye of Sargeras is, and then move to north. But we need, of course, weaken the Night Elves first, so they can't just take our cities in Kalimdor. Seems our bodyguard is almost spent. We have a few remaining fighting. We killed 65%, we killed 85%. Feat is almost a certainty. One unit can't win. Kind of regret moving this unit out of the city now, or out of the ruins. Precious general's bodyguard would have been good to have in an army, not to be wasted like this. Too bad. So this general seems to have a problem actually attacking, because it's not a ranged unit. Let's speed up this battle. He's fighting many now, Lord Sinslayer. Seems to have a problem fighting in melee. That's because the ranged attack is... he doesn't have a ranged attack like the unit. He's bodyguard, so he can't really fight. That's a problem when playing as these guys. And having a ranged bodyguard is not good for the immersion mod, I remember now. It will be bad. Close defeat. So we had 41 men, we lost all of them, but we killed 449, so at least we killed a lot of their troops. They lost 382 after 688. They have 386 remaining, so we killed half their army with one bodyguard. Okay. For the Horde Warcry. Okay, so we lost Lord Sinslayer but killed half that force. Let's see here. End of turn report. We are back as the Sindori or Blood Elves. Now we are at place 2 as the Blood Elves. Overall place 3. Faction announcement. There is a Windrunner, Mean Leader, plus 1 Dread. Farsil Dawnheart, Exotic Gift, plus 1 Influence. So I hope we can fight defensive battles. I hope no one has attacked. Okay, so we are about to fight battle. Could move ships back there. Get some more troops. Believe we could wait here for now. Okay, we could move around actually. Have a fort here too with an army. So they have a castle and a large town. It's more interesting to get the castle. We'll move down there, start the siege, build some rams. Construction completed, we have an elven port in the Sunwell. Recruitment report, we have an assassin and a diplomat in the Silver Moon capital. Let's move them out, we have the assassin here. So this is the new assassin, the Blood Elves, and the High Elves of Kael'Thas in the Reign of Chaos campaign has the same model but blue instead. Okay. Try to take out Trest Yin, their leader there. Okay. Assassin misses target Trest Yin. Okay. She didn't die at least. Continue expands King Kael'Thas. An addition has been made to this person's encourage of followers and belongings. His man's nature to follow those who are more remarkable or worthy. Master of assassins. Okay. Relations worse and discourage poor. Did they leave? I don't see any battle. I don't think any battle was fought because we still do have a full force here. Also, Kael'Thas has the Pyrestar Demolishers, Giant unit, and the Phoenix, another Giant unit. It's bigger now in the latest update compared to in the past. We had a smaller version of the Phoenix at some point. We have some Blood Shades too. Blood Blades. Well, Dora Swordmasters. They were originally named Sindora Swordmasters. The only reason they are named Kael'Thas Swordmasters is because that's a neutral name, because they are in use by both the Kingdom of Kael'Thas and the Sindora Blood Elves. But originally they were supposed to be a unique unit for the Blood Elves, so it would be wrong to remove it from the Blood Elves like the Russian team did in their sub-mod in the change, because it was originally named Sindora Swordmasters. The only reason they are named Kael'Thas is because it would sound weird if they are in the Kael'Thas faction and are named Sindora. Okay, we'll wait another turn until we take Tunkalo. Okay, we could use archers. Let's build the Hunter's Lodge in Uldor. And in the Sunwell, we could go for dirt roads. We are still recruiting troops there. And in Silver Moon, the capital, let's go for a merchant. And could also go for some arcanists, maybe. They are costly. Let's get something cheaper. Sorceress is about as costly as the others. Maybe we need to change the costs for some of the mages in a later version. Let's go for the rangers then. Okay, and can't do much more here. I think we will wait. But we might want to prevent that army from backing up the other one there. We don't want to face two armies. So, leave a unit of Spellbreakers and we'll attack. Actually, question is if we should attack. I think we will attack there too. The Risa Windrunner. We don't need anything but the rams here. The custom settlement is the type that doesn't need... you can't use siege towers or ladders against it. Okay, let's move over here with spy. Now we can see their capital, the capital of the Amani trolls. They have Warlord Sullian, their faction leader. They have Amanishri Champions bodyguard there. They also have mounted Amanishri Savages, Javelin Throwers on Bears, and Mounted Troll Warriors, their basic cavalry. And these are like basic ranged cavalry. The Lynx Warriors, they are elite infantry. Then Amanishri Berserkers. Or Axe Throwers, they are medium troops, I believe. Troll Raptor Archers, probably elite ranged cavalry. Troll Spears, they are basic or medium. Probably basic, I would say they are basic because they are the smaller trolls. And Amanishri Warmongers, they are elite infantry. And then we have some more of the Mounted Savages. Okay. The assassin is still outside of Torvata. We're besieging here with Verisa and here with Prince Lord Tamar. And yeah, the army left here, but we won't move Kael'Thas. We need to build up Ulduar. This area will probably, under Korla the Tonka, will probably give up in the next turn, so. About my diplomat, by the way. Let's move our diplomat. Maybe we could make peace with the trolls for now. Speak with the trolls. Ceasefire, trade rights, map information. Yeah, they accepted. Good. So we have peace with the Amani trolls for now. Still to cease and Dore. Blood Elves and their money. That's good, because otherwise they might attack Silvermoon while we are out of the city. That's not good. Okay. Move the assassin. Can't move the diplomat any more this turn. Okay. We are recruiting troops. Let's end the turn. Another candidate for adoption. We'll get that. We lost the general. Last time, now we have two generals here. Good. Okay, a lot of trade coalition fleets are surrounding the area of Arkoran. They do not have an army on them. Okay. Is the trade coalition preparing to move ahead? They have an area here, Eversong or Everlook or whatever. Okay, still this sea, Sindori and the Blood Elves, Sindori Blood Elves and their money. Okay, trade increase. Nasjak, Darkspire, feels unappreciated, okay. End of turn report, so the Naga are the fifth strongest faction, militarily, and the fourth overall. Faction announcement, construction report. We finished a bunch of new buildings. Unit recruitment in Eldaret, we have Naga Sea, what is the name of the... Sea snakes, okay. And we can now go for some Naga Rat of a Share, I believe, would be good. Okay. We can also build something. Go for the Elven Dockyard here. It will enable us to get the Great Sharks and the Krakens. They are still ships. That's the ship versions. Okay. Arkran, we can upgrade a wooden castle. Now we can get some Murlocs, we can get the Murloc slaves. They are the worst unit in the roster. They're basic militia. All the Murlocs are militia, but the other units are better. We have the Tidehunters and the Shore Crawlers. 5-3-2-6-5-6-6-4-4. The Tidehunters are the better ones. We'll go for them. believe they have spears instead of knives like the others. These are shields, unlike this slave unit. Okay. Let's check the other areas. Oh, we have a custom general here. Scenarios. Keeper of the Grove general. Okay. We'll upgrade this area to a wooden castle. Now we can get satyrs and murloc shore crawlers, etc. here. So the satyrs are only available in certain areas. So we can get them from the ruins of Matistra. We go for the satyr betrayers, they are the best ones. Okay, they are medium. We'll upgrade the ruins of Bashal Aran as well. Get another unit of satyr betrayers there. And in the ruins of Amet Aran, we'll also upgrade to a castle, wooden castle, and get betrayers. And in Nashville, we can get the Naga ambushers and some Murloc swamp runners. And we can build some. I believe we need some other troops, snapdragons and sea snakes. Okay. Against the Night Elves, it would be good to have. Long range units, so we'll go for the Hunter's Hall. In Solar Cell, we can actually go for some dirt roads. Or maybe we should go for the Traveler's Lodge. No. Dirt roads there. And we can get some Murlocs here too. Even Swamp Runners. Let's go for the Tide Hunters there. Blood Mist, we can upgrade to a wooden castle. And go for some Tide Hunters. In the Murloc camp, we can upgrade to a wooden castle now. Can't recruit any troops. Rainspeaker will also upgrade. Can go for the Murloc Tide Hunters there. And in Ripley Strand, an Elven Trader would be good there. And maybe some Satyr Betrayers and Murloc Swamp Runners. Actually, we can go for the Satyr Shadow Stalkers. Maybe I don't want to recruit too many troops, by the way. We are not really threatened here. We need to think of the economy. Okay, so we will not recruit troops here. For now, we could move Lady Vash and her troops down to Ripley Strand, maybe. Maybe I won't do that now. Okay, we had an army moving under Royal Guard Nyantus. Okay, so their army could attack the ruins there. I think I will attack a burden.
Yes, my lord. This is where we shall meet the enemy.
Need to attack there. So they have Roll Bear Mantle here. He has a unique Druid Bear form strat model. Okay, and he has a bodyguard of Sentinels. Bodyguard, the generic bodyguard for the Night Elves. And he has Night Elven Spearmen, Archers, Shadowling Guardians, they are elite. Infantry and the Night Elven Warriors, okay. So they have gathered quite the force over there. Let's move this army there then. To defend better against this force, they have Firbolgs. Firbolg Maulers, infantry. Dryads. And the general with the bodyguard of Keepers of the Grove, they are really good mages and cavalry. Okay. So we could attack somewhere. So leave the slaves there and move this force. This is the generic general now. The old Lady Vash. would actually attack and end this. So a candidate for adoption. Yeah, we could use another hero here. We'll go for it. Mission success. So we had taken Tunkalo, they gave up. Good. End of turn report. Okay. Nothing important had happened. In Silvermoon we have a merchant's wharf, and in the Sunwell we have dirt roads now. Okay. Recruitment report. Sunwell with Silver God Lancers and Blood Knights and Hawkstrider Knights. So the Cavalry has arrived. And a merchant in Silver Moon. What merchant first? 126 florins from this ruined cloth. Yeah, we'll move him out. So this is the Blood Elven merchant, the male merchant. I believe the High Elven is a blue one with blonde hair. So the only difference is the skin. Okay, and finally we are ready to attack somewhere. So we can move out the actual general. But I don't trust. Do they have? They have a general here, not the Plaguebringer. Lich's bodyguard. Okay, they're liches, they're really dangerous. Undead champions, skeleton archers, skeleton spearmen, skeleton raiders. I only fear a lich bodyguard, a really dangerous mage. Okay, so I probably want to attack with... I probably want to control the units. This area has... Baron Bloodbane, Death Knight, I think, but with a Lich Bodyguard, okay. And they have a huge army here. I think we will just wait there. We moved out troops. Maybe we'll move and stop the siege. So... Sink the army. Could move over here, actually. And we can move an archer unit down there too. And this archer unit could also move there. We'll lift the siege and prepare to attack this force here. So poor relations with the Lord on Remnant and the Scarlet Crusade. So Heartglen and the Tyr's Hand became the Scarlet Crusade together, and they moved the fleet to Northrend, where they have the Scarlet's holdout. Okay, in Lord the fleet was wrecked before by a storm before they reached Northrend, but in this game that is all about alternative history, they reached Northrend and set up a base. Okay, and the Scarlet Crusade is unique to the Frozen Throne campaign. The Lordaeron has Dalaran from the start. The Forsaken is holding Lordaeron itself. So there are like the Scarlet Crusade and Lordaeron. But Lordaeron only has Dalaran and is led by Garritos, the Marshal. Okay, we have the Assassin here. We can move her towards the Scourge. We have the Spy. We can move her down here. You can see the Scarlet Crusade. We have Grand Scarlet Crusaders here. Really cool unit. And some Mounted Paladins, another really good unit. this is a castle. Tier sand. Okay, we have the diplomat, we can move her as well. Sorceress, diplomat. Okay, the fleet can move to the port here. So we could fight a battle here against the undead. They have more armies, it would be nice to use two armies against one there. But I think we will attack in two places at once. Okay, let's check Northrend. So we have gotten Tunkalo. We have no economy, I see. That sucked. We can't destroy any buildings either. Okay, we will just have to move this army. Leave one unit of spellbreakers. Move. We have a general here. We move out this army as well. Strike against the Scourge. Move in this general into Uldar. And stop the construction. We are not constructing anywhere. We can stop the recruitment there as well. It's not good that we do not have any good economy. We need to spend some of our armies. We are moving Haldron Brightwing down to attack an area over here. And we will move Kael'Thas to attack an area over here. And can't recruit or construct anything. Currently we will also use up our troops. It's time to attack. And we can start with the siege actually. I believe we are ready. So we have this army. We could just auto-resolve, but I usually won't auto-resolve. If I lead like this I usually will, but as this is the first battle we will play it of course. To save the game, and we will have two saves in case one is corrupted. Okay, and I need to go do some personal businesses currently, so see you soon. So hello, I'm back. Hello. Okay. So I'm back. I just checked the microphone. So we are going to fight the battle here. We are attacking the Scourge in this area. I don't remember the name. Not the Plaguebringer is holding the settlement. And we are going to attack. Let's fight the battle on the battle map.
For the moment, the fortune of battle goes our way. Trade remains as such.
So this is the army of Risa Windrunner. Start deployment. So we have an army here, full-sized army. We have the Blood Blades. They can be in shield formation. Heavy infantry, then we have the Sindori Swordmasters. They are named Kael'Thas because of the fact I mentioned earlier, but we can call them Sindori Blood Swordmasters here, as they were originally named. Then we have the Brightwind Vindicator. So if you're going to remove this from any faction, then remove them from the High Elves and rename them to Sindori Blood Swordmasters instead. Okay, then we have the Brightwing Vindicators. Also the new strat model general, generic general model is using this now. We We have the Arcane Guardians, their golems, and we have these Blood Shades holding the rams. I don't think it's a good idea that they are holding the rams. So we'll move them to the side. I think another unit should be holding the ram. Let's see here. That one unit of Swordmasters can be holding it, and the other unit could be held. The other ram could be held by the Blood Blades. We have more of the Swordmasters, Brightwing Vindicators, Arcane Guardians. We have some. We had some Spellbreakers too. Actually, I changed my mind. The Swordmaster should not be there either then. Instead, Spellbreaker should of course handle the ram. They are more of a medium unit than an elite unit. Okay. We had some archers too, of course. Put them in loose formation. We had no rangers, we had some mages though. The mages over here. And then we have Verisa, she might be a ranger. Yeah. She has this ranger unit as a bodyguard. An unusual bodyguard and her own unique skin. Let's place her in loose formation too. This is Verisa Windrunner. Silver hair and green skin for the armor and cape. Her bow is green, while the unit has different colors for their bows. Okay. Let's start the battle and pause the game. Victor seems certain only a fool could lose this battle. They have some troops outside of the palisade, some undead troops. Most of them are here. The entrance is on the other side. We start behind the settlement. Okay, we will need to move around. There is no gate. We can just move in. It's a village type settlement. And we don't need a gate. A ram, I mean. We don't need a ram then. So drop it and it's time to harass the enemy. Send forth the archers to harass these skeletons here. Actually, I don't like those liches. We will attack the liches with the archers. And our mages too could attack them. The priests of the sun, the arcanists, and the Blood Mages. So these are the priests of the sun. Same model in use as the priest on the map. We have the arcanists, better mages. And we have the bodyguards of King Kael'Thas here, the Blood Mages, but this is not the bodyguard unit, this is the Blood Mage unit, but the same unit is used by his bodyguard. We have the archers. Let's just attack. Don't go too close to the mage. We have lost some units. Our archers need to take care of their skeleton archers. I forgot that they had that. Okay, our general can also attack their skeleton archers. Okay. I don't like that they have fire at will on. Just attack their skeleton archers. So the battle didn't go too well at the start. They killed quite a few. Now we are firing back at them. So they had an archer unit. I forgot about that. In the past, the undead usually didn't have any archers. I added that to them. Used to be, I believe they had dismounted archers, but they didn't have mounted archers. Now I remember. I added that to Skirk, but they used to be unique to Forsaken in the past. So you killed quite a few of their skeleton archers. Good. So our archers are different. Hairstyles and different heads. Seems to be mostly the same hairstyle. Some of them have different ones, different colors. They're moving out cavalry shit. Didn't have any cavalry in this army. That sucks. Move some arcane guardians there to handle the cavalry. Move away from there then. Let's move out of there. They're pretty fast when running, so. But the cavalry are probably too fast. Orcan guardians need to intervene fast before that cavalry have taken out my archers. They're moving out troops too, shit. I need the priests to attack that lich. And these guys too. They had fired will on, that's why they didn't do what I had clicked for them to do. Too bad, I need to deactivate that when I start battles going forward. Okay. No more fired will. And the spellbreakers could be sent forward to handle that skeleton unit. Nowhere the skeleton cavalry is there, I see. Just attacked the cavalry and ignored their infantry. Ah, they moved out their lich. They're really dangerous. Move over there, I don't want you to die. I don't want the lich to kill my arcane guardians. Stop moving.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men
so they can fight here.
And forging a worthy victory.
Okay, so it took out most of their archers. The mages didn't have any good view, so they couldn't really fire at them. There is our general here. They are killing their skeleton archers, I see. Let's attack the lich instead. Return with the archers and attack the lich. They can fire over walls and palisades, unlike the mages. It was too OP to have mages that could fire over walls, like in the past. Our arcane guardians are doing a good job. Send in our spellbreakers too, into the melee. I don't want the hero to move too close. Let's fire from here. Risa shouldn't be in Lee. Good, she's firing at the Lich General. Lich's bodyguard. The spellbreakers have entered the battle. Good. I believe I did increase their stats from in the past. They are better now than in the past, but they are still not that good. They are more medium than basic now. Good, rangers can kill the liches from that area. Zoom in the map so they have all their forces here. Okay, let's move in the spellbreakers, but I need need liches to be dead before moving in any infantry. They suck in melee too. We might be able to attack them with the Arcane Guardians. Let's fast forward. Firing of arrows. We don't have limited arrow ammunition either.
To our Lord. Our
general is dead.
The
not the Playbringer is dead. Yeah, he took out the general. Okay, so the archers can stop firing. They haven't stopped already. Send a horn at the general. We'll send in the spellbreaker to handle the undead champions. Don't really need to play as the hero in this battle. She also has a ranged bodyguard, which is problematic if using the bodyguard, because then the camera zooms in on the projectile when using the immersion mod if they fire their projectiles, meaning we can't really use her bodyguard unless we do not use the tool, I mean the mod, immersion mod. So we have 124 spellbreakers here, fighting 9 undead champions. All of the others seem to be dead. 10% enemies killed, 8% allies killed. Yeah, we have won the battle. Taken this graveyard from the Scourge. Sun Sail and Shoreditch or whatever. So they will fight to the death, of course, because they have no morale, but they do not have the numbers anymore, so they are doomed. Okay, that one took Windrunner running towards the center.
My lord, our men have taken control of the city.
Leave it on. Yeah, we have won this. Why we haven't won yet. They had some units here. Let's kill them. We still had some skeleton archers there. Let's fire them with the bodyguard. So Risa will do the final blow. Discards in this area. Move in the spellbreakers too. Have 121 spellbreakers left.
The battle is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory will be ours. This is a clear
we won the battle
that goes to only men of great virtue and valor.
All right, clear victory. Risa Windrunner had 1633 men, lost 126 men, remaining 1507. And we killed about 522. Very good. They lost everyone. They killed only 145. Battle statistics. So our Blood Mages killed 176. Our Arcane Guardians killed 66, and our archers killed 89 and 60 respectively. Spellbreakers killed 35. And what about our bodyguard killed 92? Okay. The best unit was the Blood Mages, of course. Continue. Yeah, we can continue. The other chieftains and I, we drank Manroth's blood troll. We brought this curse upon ourselves. Grom Hellscream, warlord of the Warsong clan. And he is dead in this campaign. Manoroth is also dead. Okay. The Pit Lord Manoroth. So it took Fairbreeze. I was wrong, it was Fairbreeze. This is Sunsail and George. Okay. Okay. We need money, Florence. We will exterminate the undead here, just like they exterminated our population. Okay, didn't lose a lot of troops. Can move here. We don't really want to move Verisa there. Let's move there with her army to one unit there. Okay, so this army will be moved there. So there are two armies against their one army, giving us the upper hand. And I will control Prince Lord Tamar, Teron. Trade increase, Rise of Windrunner winning first, plus one dread. Enemy army routes, and there is, yeah. Resistance futile, Fairbreeze, that's good. We had no buildings to raise. Trait increase, where is a Windrunner, cruel leader. Continue expands, where is a Windrunner. Torture of undead, okay. So we will control Prince Lord Tamar Teron. So they have two forces here. Too bad, we move this army down there. Yes, my lord. Fuck, that army back down. We'll move this army in. She needs an army. Can't attack this time. We'll move this army towards the army in Sunsail and Chorich. This unit out.
Onward. It is a beautiful position to understand.
Could probably attack from that side too, I see.
Orders. Your will. Your majesty. Yes.
Alright.
Orders. Yes, your majesty.
Move back this four layer unit for now. But we will later add reason to that army. Relations version, the Scourge Abysmal. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, we can't do much more this time. Oh, we got some troops when we completed the mission. Let's move this force. So Verisa can move back to Silver Moon.
Yes.
Maybe. We will move this unit out again. We reset to this army. And move a unit of spellbreakers. Oh, a unit of arcanists to Fairbreeze. Okay. Move this army towards Fairbreeze. They don't like that we will face two armies here. So we obviously need to wait them out then. Or place another army here and attack from both sides. Okay, let's end the turn. Construction complete. We have dirt roads and solar cell. The ire. We'll avoid recruiting more troops for now. Need money. Okay. We have some troops in Bloodmist. We have Marluk Tidehunters. And in Solar Cell, Marluk Tidehunters. In Nashville, we have Naga Ambushers. In Nashville, we have Marluk Swamprunners. And in Arkoran, we have Marluk Tidehunters. Okay. Actually, we could wait with upgrading this stuff. We don't really need to upgrade right now. I do need a Hunter's Hall in Nashville. And in Ruins of Amid Air, and we could actually use that. Yeah, in Kalimdor, I believe we need an upgrade. Need the Elven Trader, and there we could also have an upgrade. Okay, as for attacking, could attack a Verdin now.
Yes. Crossing for battle.
So what do they have? They have a large town. We don't really need any siege then. Even battle till they have pretty strong troops here. I don't want to face all of that. They have a full army here too. You need to defend against, including Maeve Shadowsong. Okay. I would like to move these troops. Don't have a port here. Okay, we have an army here. Could attack Nendis now. I think we'll move a unit back. The Marluk slaves. Then we'll move this force here, the siege, then this is a large town, then we don't need towers and ladders, because it's a village. We'll move Illidan to the army. Makes sense for Illidan to be the one that takes the city. He looks really good in battle, on the map, his battle model. Okay, relations worse and the Horde poor. Yeah, the Horde is allied to the Night Elves. If we check the diplomacy, we can see that our ally, the Sindora, is only allied to us. The Burning Legion is allied to the Dark Irons, Dark Iron Dwarves, and the Grubashi Trolls as well. No longer allied to the Scourge, they are at war with the Scourge. In the other campaign, they are allied to the Scourge. But here they have become enemies. Okay, and you can see that the Naga enemies, Lordaeron, is allied to the Kingdom of Stormwind, Terramor, Kasmodan, and the Kingdom of Stromguard. Terramor is allied to Lordaeron, Stormwind, Kasmodan, the Night Elves, Kingdom of Stromguard, the Horde, and the Trade Coalition. And Night Elves, or allied Terramor, the Horde, and the Trade Coalition. The Trade Coalition is neutral between the Horde and the Alliance, of course. But the best way to be neutral here is to be allied in this in medieval total war. The Scourge has no allies, okay. Same with Scarlet Crusade, and the Vrykul, and Kirai has Azul, the Kingdom of Azul Nerub as an ally. And there are many trolls. They have the Dark Iron Dwarves, the Dark Horde, and the Burning Legion as an ally. Okay. They can't attack this time. I'd like to send some reinforcements, but we have emptied these areas. They won't reach the area in time, and we need this army to defend against this army. We have to attack this time. Or skip attacking. We have... these casters are like ordinary archers in strength. I believe they have two strong forces. We will wait. We won't really attack this time. How long can they last? 6 turns. We'll wait for now. See if they do anything in the other areas. So we don't want to recruit any troops. Could probably move some troops to...
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Let's move this force.
Move out! We march no further today, Lord. Orders?
And move an army here too. Lady Vash, we will combine these forces. Okay, let's end the turn. So the Night Elves did attack and are sailing out. So I guess we will have to fight this battle, but they've lost lots of druids. I don't like that. A total advantage in casters. They are casters, these guys. So that gives them a huge advantage. Also, they have mostly really good archers, while we have sucky javeliners. We have good infantry, but they have a lot of ranged units. Moonstrikers. Archers. Yeah, they have very good stuff compared to our army. But I don't want to retreat on the strat, but we'll retreat in battle. Okay, let's start the game. The battle, I mean. Let's save the game. Start.
The troops are assembled. Prepare for battle. Enemy have brought up more men.
So this is the custom general, Nayentus, the Royal Guard. He looked better than I had thought he would. Pause the game, we'll drop all the siege. So they are sailing out. Oh, I forgot, we are really slow. If we are retreating on the battlefield, they might run us down. We need to retreat, but not with every unit, maybe. Let's see here. We'll drop all the siege. We don't need it in this battle. And our long range units can attack. We'll lose formation on them. fire ammo for the spell callers. Group the long range units, and the infantry will also be grouped into one group. Okay. Actually, we might sacrifice the army, but retreat with the general. So we'll see here. I don't want to lose my unique Naga Royal Guard custom general. He's cool. His arm seems to be a little bugged, maybe, but yeah, it's still a unique general. Okay. First thing we will do is send in the Myrmidons against the Night Elven Spearmen. Some Guardians of the Abyss, maybe. Maybe we won't send them in. Yeah, I think we will send them in, because otherwise they will get to fire at us. Oh, they're moon strikers, etc. Okay. To be honest, all of these guys could attack. Different target for everyone. Okay. Okay, so all the infantry has been ordered to attack. Our Naga ambushers to attack too. We can wait with that. War cry. So these are the Naga Myrmidons. Some of them are not using tridents for some reason. Maybe it's because they were holding towers and such. They're sending forth their Night Elven Spearmen. These are the ones that are more uniform, the armor upgrade too. Their Sentinel's Bodyguard. The Druid Custom Hero General. Yeah, there's Brawl Bear Mantle in human form. Okay. I don't like that my Sea Callers have fired will on. Stop firing. And you will attack their moon strikers, the armored archers, the night elves. Attack their druids too. Okay, and the Naga ambushers, they can attack, they have low range. They will just attack their infantry here. Okay, let's start the battle.
The battle is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory will be ours.
So the Guardians of the Abyss are bigger and stronger than the Myrmidons. And a lot bigger than the Night Elves, but still not as big as the Rats of Shara. the druids of the Talon can actually turn into birds. Shame it started to lag when they started to fight inside of this area. I had hoped that wouldn't happen with the village, but the Night Elven cities have that problem when you have zoomed in. Alright. That's a disappointment. Started to lag quite a lot in this settlement. As soon as the fighting started. Not before the fighting started. Hopefully it will disappear. I believe it's the settlement.
Praise to our Lord. Our men have slain.
Oh, they have somehow attacked me here too. Sent out a unit. Fucking idiot. Royal Bearmantle is dead, their general. Naga Seacolors will have to attack these guys now to help the general. So I don't like that they are not firing. Let's just enable fire at will then. Guys should attack their unit here before they kill my general. Some of them managed to get through and move around. They were smarter than expected. So these are the Naga Royal Guards, elite infantry. Oh, they have some cavalry here too. Not good. Kill the cavalry then. You can't run away when they have cavalry. Actually, I want my bodyguard to attack their tigers. But if they are attacking the sea coolers. So we are busy fighting these guys. Not good. They will slay these guys. Hopefully we can break the Night Elven spear and their warriors. Their army is still fighting their army.
Unwise to praise the day before sunset.
Good that we are firing at them here.
The battle and forging a worthy victory.
Stop moving. And attack. Their tiger mounts succeeded in killing one unit of sea callers. They are our archers pretty much. Mages with very weak attack. No, they had another unit moved in here. They had more troops than I had hoped. Zoom in on the map, we can see that they had quite a few troops. That's not good. I underestimated them. We have to move back some of our Myrmidons, our Guardians of the Abyss. Let's move back the Myrmidons there too.
My lord, the tide of battle seems to have turned against us. We must act and halt this turn of events.
our sequels are finally doing something good in the battle. Need to help our general here before I kill him. I want the general to take care of their tigers.
Only half our force remains.
It's important that the general survives. Sent in a unit of Myrmidons too. Shame it started to lag as soon as battle started in the village. Interested in this battle, saving the general Niantus. Seem to be winning against the Moonstrikers here in the city. So that's good at least. We have killed 30%, we killed 66%, so we will probably lose the battle, unfortunately. Our sequelers are firing the wrong way. But I don't really care right now. Attack the tigers now. Nagra will guard. Okay, so the Guardians of the Abyss will handle their infantry here. I don't want you to pick up the ladders. I want you to kill the troops. Don't pick up the stuff there, just attack the troops there. Okay. Naga Royal Guard will handle their tigers. I don't want the sequelers to attack there. Should attack the troops. Like how the Moonstrikers look too. They are fan made from Warcraft 3 underground. So our Guardians of the Abyss are holding the line there, getting some help from the Naga Ambushers, the Ambleaners, and the Naga Seacallers. Tigers have retreated. I think it's time to move. Retreat with the bodyguard. Well, these guys will fight to the death. We have broken their volunteers.
Our enemy has lost his stomach to fight. We must push our advantage.
So they still had a few alive of the tigers. As long as our general can retreat and leave the battlefield without being hunted down, that's good.
Mentioned by the Almighty Lord, or a military genius can bring us victory from this disgrace.
I think we should kill these guys too. Let's return with the infantry to that battle. What are you doing? You should retreat. We are still fighting the Moonstrikers and the Druids of the Talon here. I prefer fighting the Druids in melee. or fighting them in long range. They are really good in long range. They seem to be winning the melee. Okay. Our infantry are doing poorly. Let's lose formation on them and charge. All of them. Our general might be able to retreat. That's good news. They have bought time for them to retreat. The lagging disappeared mostly. That's also good. Yeah, the Moonstrikers are really cool. wait a second, I shouldn't use that when they are retreating. We have 25 Naga Royal Guard still alive. So we've killed 39%, we killed 82%. General is doing it weird with the arm animation being different. Because its animation is the same as the Medusa Matriarchs. They have about the same size. A different animation. Let's wait there. I want to check what the army is up to. Okay, so the Moonstrikers still fighting here. Some archers. Guardians of the Abyss. Oh, they sent in all their archers in melee. That means they have no ammunition left, no arrows left. They also have swords. We have to fight our guardians and myrmidons. And also our javeliners. We can also fight in melee. We have myrmidons.
Or a military genius really can bring us victory from this disgrace.
Attack those guys. Okay. So the ambushers are ordered to attack. Let's attack with the sea callers as well. So the tigers took out one of our three sea caller units. So we only have two left. Zoom out on the map, we can see our general is safe. We are doing a good job cutting down their archers. They are still firing from over here, their Moonstrikers. So these are the Moonstrikers. Maybe they have no ammo left. I'm just worried about their numbers. These arrows, these archers still have ammo. Of course the druids are dangerous in long range. We almost have no infantry left now. Not good. good at all. We also have another army outside of the other ruins. We might lose two armies on this side and lose the areas that we have here on this side of Kael'Thas. But the losses will help the economy at least. Maybe we can do a better job from Nordrum then. If we lose the areas in Kael'Thas, but we need to move Illidan to Nordrum. If that's the case, then he need to run away like he did in Lore. Fled after taking Nendis, he made a port there, and then he fled to the Eye of Sargeras with me in Shadowzone hunting. They have soon won the melee fight. I believe it's time to attack with the ambushers in melee. Fire. Let's attack the units that are ranged. Oh, they are. I changed my mind. They need to go in melee now. I had some ambushers here. They have a different weapon than the Myrmidons. Instead of tridents, they have some kind of short sword, a long knife. They will fight now.
I pray the course of this battle changes, because defeat seems almost certain.
We lost, man. We lost Naga. Well, the sea coolers will continue to fire upon the enemy. We killed 48%, we killed 93%. So we clearly lost. These mages are too weak. They're supposed to be just an archer unit using mage fire, so unlike other mages, they are really weak. And cheap too. Broken through. Sea coolers will continue to fire. Until they have no ammo left. Left, not this unit at least. maybe this one has or does. Yeah, they seem to have arrows left. They are moving out. Even have a unit of cavalry here. One left. So that bug is not a part of the actual mod. It's more of a result of the kill the general. Now his men will lose heart. Captain Kael'Thas, but we killed Brawl Bearmantle, they're really an out there. Okay, so that bug with the rider is because of the tool, not because of the mod. Sea callers will continue to fire. Killing some of them. 51% enemies killed. They killed 96% of our force too. Still had Druids of the Talon. They have quite large forces still standing. Try to kill as many as we can. Just fast forward. Don't need to have fired wheel on. Change that. Stop firing. Attack. So these are female Naga, but not the best looking. It's time to retreat. Retreat with the rest of them. I wonder if they will follow or not. Look at the carnage here. Lots of dead night elves and Naga. It's a clear victory for them. 19 and 18 alive of the sea callers, respectively. We'll retreat with the general too. Naga are so slow on land that you need to move the general far ahead of the others in case the worst happens. So the general is safe. The Naga's fled, left the battlefield. So we'll also manage to save some of the sea callers. honors. Because the Night Elves didn't hunt us. Maybe they have trouble moving out of the village. It's a large town, but the village isn't used by the village, the town, and the large town.
Our army is
other
tiring.
Settlement levels are using the large city. Because the town and large town models that were used in older versions, they lagged too much. I mean, this battle lagged when we had full armies fighting inside the city, but stopped lagging. But the other settlements didn't stop lagging.
We have been dealt a stinging defeat today.
Yeah, clear defeat. So we had 1446, Nyentus had 1446, Naga and lost 1385, have 61 remaining alive. We killed 1094 enemies, so we killed a lot of enemies. Brawl Beermantle died, he had 2019 troops, lost 753, have 1266 remaining alive, killed 1204. Zero while they were running away, okay. So he killed more than he lost. Captain Canerus had 305 men, lost 262, and 43 remaining, killed 158, okay. And battle statistics. So Naga Royal Guard killed 250 enemies, that's actually good. And the Guardians of the Abyss killed 127, 87, and 30. Then we had the Myrmidons, they killed 38. I see. Well, the Guardians of the Abyss killed 127, 87, and 122. And the Sea Callers killed 80. I believe they killed 89 and 88. Okay, and there are some others too, okay. Guardians of the Abyss 114, okay. Let's return to the map. You lied to your men and betrayed the mercenaries who fought for you. What's happening to you, Arthas? Muradin Bronzebeard. That's the Dwarven Prince. Prince Muradin. Killed by Arthas in the Frozen Throne campaign. Or it was the Reign of Chaos, and I don't remember.
Breaking the siege. This is not good, Lord. The enemy have laid siege upon us.
Bride presented. I don't need that. Gift. You have been rewarded with 3,000 florins. That's good, but you're still minus. Civil disorder in Tunkalo and in Uldor. Not good. So our back is the Sindori or Blood Elves. Captain there. I'd like to kill their generals. We have Ras Frost Whisper here. But it feels more right to use sabotage. We'll do that. I believe we succeeded. Sabotage mission success. So, Rahane of Everson Woods. It's a suitable picture too, as our assassin looks exactly like this. Okay, Necropolis, thanks to guile, cunning, and possibly some good fortune, our hidden operative has managed to destroy the building you ordered sabotaged. So complete was its destruction that until these unwitting fools can rebuild and repair the damage done, they will not be able to make use of it at all. Good. We destroyed the Necropolis. Side of Tranquillian, held by the Scourge, where they have a general Ras Frost Whisperer and another Lich Bodyguard. Smooth Spellbreakers into Fairbreeze. Army could be moved here. fuck. That was a mistake. So I couldn't attack from this side. Let's see here. There is no auto save, fuck. Okay, so we have no choice but to accept that movement. So I don't want them to have two armies against one of mine. Turn sound to surrender, 3. We'll probably sally out. We need to move the other army back there. Okay. So we'll sit here. Need to attack somewhere. Fast to get the economy back on track. An arm here, and they wrote in the saying a necromancer, the bodyguard of Death Knights. They have a regal general here, Agneta Tirsdottir. Or Agneta Tirsdottir. Okay, some regal zombies and skeletons. She's still holding Stratholm. Two armies here. Duke Rage Reaver, an army. He has a Lich Bodyguard. And a captain, okay. Let's move the cavalry. into the city. Okay. Let's end the turn. We have no money. The trade coalition has a huge fleet outside of our capital. Settlement besieged Nasivel by the Night Elves, so they have besieged the capital. Army. So he fled with some troops, but I don't know where they fled. Ah, Nyentus fled here to the ruins of Battle Aaron.
Your orders, number one. Yes.
Could move some troops. So he could move to ruins of Matistra. Defend together with these two units. So we are stronger there. So we have three generals there now. Warlock camp. Let's recruit some Satyr Shadow Stalkers there. Here or two. And here we can stop recruiting. Maybe not. We have three units. What do they have? They have four units. We might be able to hold them, not sure. Depending on what they have. Ah, they have an elite infantry unit. Better units than us. Not good. I think we will lose. Let's stop rebuilding that. Let's destroy this building to get some money. Warlock camp. I think we have lost this area anyway. Let's destroy. Don't need that either. Or that it was almost finished, but they will probably take those areas in a few turns, in one turn or so. We will continue to build here and recruit some Satyr Shadow Stalkers. Well, yeah. End of turn report. The Scourge is the strongest in everything. But financials. Agent found Eldarit Horde. The Horde has sent an agent to Eldarit. Faction announcements. Nyentus, Fair Fighter plus one chivalry. Warlord Kalitresh feels unappreciated. Minus one loyalty. Trillion. Astrologer, minus one pity, plus one command, out of the blood cursed, biographer, plus one authority. Construction complete, we have an elven trader in Ripple Strand. Recruitment report, we got some new units, good units. Relations improved with our legion, good. Relations report, we have good relations with blood elves. And poor relations with Terramore and Lordaeron. Okay. So we are about to attack Nendis. Also have some new elite units there. Could move the Murlocs out of the army. And move these elite units into the army. Okay. And I believe we can attack, but we'll check the areas in Northrend first. Move this force. And Lady Vash will move closer next turn. They will reach each other. Then we have Solar Cell here. We have no fleet here anyway. Alright, it's time to attack, I believe. Yes. So we have Illidan and the two generic generals, Nasjek Darkspine and Vespira Tidewrath. Alright. Dear Army, they have a custom general here, Naisha, using the generic Huntress model on the map because she's a Huntress, but otherwise it's used for the generic generals too of the Night Elves. And then she has her own custom model, which is a Huntress, in battle as well. So she has some druids, that's not good, but we have some good stuff here too. Okay, I will save here. And this will end the first episode, because it's become pretty long now that I'm playing as two factions at once. So, this is where the first episode will end. We will continue another time.